We have with us Dr. Avinashi Kapoor, who is the Dean of Student Welfare at University of Delhi South Campus. He is the chief guest of this Envisage 2014. Sir, welcome.
Thank you.
Sir, we would like to know, you the Joint Secretary, Dean of Student Welfare at this University of Delhi. So you're like closely connected to students in this.
Definitely.
So you, Envisage is wholly controlled by students, organized by students. Students are the major hand behind this whole event. So do you think they were successful in giving them their maximum output and making this whole event a successful event?
You see, the right from the inception of Institute of Information and Informatics and Communication, the emphasis was given on leadership development quality. How can you achieve it? You can achieve only if you give responsibility to intelligent students. And over the years, we have observed that they do much better job than many experienced people. So we are happy, and they do very good job.
Sir, you said you were the one of the parties who helped in forming this Institute of Informatics and Communication. What were the key challenges or the key factors that that were involved in this whole procedure?
See, from middle of 90s, the information technology sector became the prime employer in the country. Then in 96-97, late Professor Man Singh was director of South Campus. He took help of myself, Professor P.C. Mathur, Professor K.N. Tripathi, and we moved around all IT industries, major IT industries, and tried to find out that what is the state of art first, and then what is the requirement of those companies so that our student gets directly absorbed. As such, university's main role is not employment. Our main role is to improve the mental status of young generation so that they become a better member of the society. But of late, we realized that was the time when we were student, and the thing was the thinking level, the mental maturity level of the student must grow. But as time passed by, we realize that university, apart from technical institutes, and there are many good IITs, they are producing many good engineers, university should also play a role in developing courses which is employable. This was the thought process, and with this thought process, late Professor Abhay Man Singh, then director of South Campus, with his team, as I have already described, we moved around and met all the major players in IT, CEOs of major players in IT, and as we are all researchers with great experience, we could extract what do they demand. Based on their demand, we formulated a syllabi which is slightly different than what others are offering, so that we become unique and more marketable than many VTechs. And so far we have succeeded in that. So I am happy that the seed which was sown by late Professor Abhay Man Singh and others is growing, and it will keep growing. As you know, the 21st century is going to be IT era only.
So basically, you had some visions and missions when you when you were developing this institute, and you still think that all the visions and missions are being accomplished as and when the whole time passes by.
It's a difficult question. We have not been able to get right kind of professionals as we had thought we will get, because these people are a good IT professional has a tremendous market demand. University has a limitation. This is a community university, central university, where salary structure in 20th century, that is late 90s, was pretty low. And that did not motivate the real experts of IT to join university and train human resources, bright human resources we are getting here. So that deficiency is there. But now, I think, and the government policy is changing, they have realized that you have to invest in the education sector. Then only country can become better. So I am sure 7th pay commission will have a lucrative salary for professors, and I am sure, because after all, government job provides one thing for sure, that is security of life, which is not there in private sector. So I'm sure after some few years we will find the right kind of people. You see, bina guru ke gyan nahi hota hai. Self-driven people are very little. Everybody cannot be Ramanujam. Even Ramanujam could not have become popular if foreigner would not have taken him to Cambridge. When he came, when he went to Cambridge, then only his intelligence and the mathematical capability, extraordinary mathematical capability that he had, was exploited. And he became a known person. So you need ambience, you need param gurus to become perfect person. So to that extent, I feel that we are lacking a little bit, but our respected Vice Chancellor, Padma Shri Shri Professor Dinesh Singh, he is trying his level best to increase the level of enlightenment in this university. I am associated with this university. I had been student of this university when this university was supposed to be one of the leading universities across the world. And slowly some decline came, but with brilliant vision and leadership quality of present Vice Chancellor, Padma Shri Professor Dinesh Singh, I think it will again regain the lost laurels.
Sir, you just mentioned you're not finding the right kind of IT professionals for this department. So according to you, what are the key features or the key pointers that you think are necessary in becoming in that Param Guru which you're searching for?
Key thing is, as I said in my talk also, that programming is more of an art than science. Or you can say a science dominated by art. Everybody cannot become a good programmer. You can become a programmer very comfortably, but you cannot become a genuine programmer unless otherwise you have that art built in you. And if you want that your students should become expert programmers, they are very good coders. Our product do coding job beautifully, which in itself is a big art. But I would love that the tree expands, not only coding job, programming job, like what the leader Bill Gates did. That kind of student, motivated student, who Bill Gates left MIT after first year and devoted his life to software engineering. And so that is why I say degree and scientific knowledge is not the only basis for becoming a good programmer. Bill Gates is an example. He became the leader of the world with Microsoft company. So if we have to produce Bill Gates in Delhi University, we have to get artists like Bill Gates. Then only we will be able to produce hundreds of Bill Gates. Search is on. I am a born optimist, and I am sure we will be able to get one.
So this was Dr. Avinashi Kapoor, who was explaining us the journey of this Delhi University from 70s to the 21st century. So Dr. Avinashi Kapoor is a very optimistic person, and he's of the opinion that he'll find the right kind of the Param Guru who could get to train the right kind of Bill Gates in this department also. Thank you, sir.